गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, साई राम, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल आर डूइंग गुड एंड सेफ एट होम, राइट? सो बिफोर द वेकेशन वी सॉ चैप्टर 1. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी आवर न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 2, रोमन न्यूमरल्स. आर यू ऑल रेडी टू लिसन? यस. शैल वी स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास? So before going into the class, we'll have a quick recall of what you have studied in class 3. Yes? Roman numeral system was developed by the ancient Romans. Roman numeral system was developed by the ancient Romans. Who developed the Roman numbers, numerals? Yes, Romans, ancient Romans. It is based on 7 letters of the alphabet. It is based on the 7 letters of the alphabet. It is based on the 7 letters of the alphabet. I, V, X, L, C, D, M. It is based on 7 letters of the alphabet. All the numbers are written using either one letter or a combination of letters. All the numbers are written using either one letter or a combination of letters. How we'll represent? We'll represent using either one letter or a combination of different letters. There is no letter representing zero. There is no letter to represent the number zero. Let me repeat. Roman numeral system was developed by the ancient Romans. It is based on 7 letters of the alphabet. It is based on the 7 letters of the alphabet. All the numbers are written using either one letter or a combination of letters. There is no letter representing zero. Next we have the 7 letters of the alphabet. I, V, X, L, C, D and M. Now shall we see the values of these letters? Yes. So value of I is? Yes, 1. Now you are going to answer these questions. What is the value of I? 1. Now tell me, what is the value of V? You have studied in your previous class, right? Class 3. So what is the value of V? Yes, 5. Very good. So value of V is 5. What is the value of X? Yes, 10. Value of X is 10. Value of L is 50. What is the value of L? 50. What is the value of C then? 100. What is the value of C? 100. Now what is the value of D? 500. Value of D is 500. And the value of M is 1000. Value of M is 1000. Let me repeat. I, the value of I is 1. V is 5. Value of X is 10. Value of L is 50. Value of C is 100. And value of D is 500. And value of M is 1000. Next. Which of the following is not a valid Roman numeral? Now you are going to answer this question now. Which of the following is not a valid Roman numeral? A is VV, B XIX, C is VIII, D is XXX. Now tell me, which is not a valid Roman numeral? A, yes, very good. A is the correct option. A, VV, because V cannot be repeated 2 times. Yes. So second B option, the answer is XIX is 10. and IX is 9. So value is for second one is 19. For C option is VIIA. V value of V is 5. 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So 5 plus 3 is 8. So value of X is 10. So 10 plus 10 plus 10, 30. So other three is a valid Roman numeral. Only this is not a valid Roman numeral. Yes. Next one. Put the correct sign greater than, less than, or equal to. Now you are going to tell me the answer now. Put the correct sign greater than, less than, or equal to. A sum 25, and you are going to compare now 25 with XV. 25 XV. Now tell me what is the value of XV. So what is the value of X? So 10. Value of X is 10. And what is the value of V? Yes, 5. So 10 plus 5 is 15. What is the value of XV now? 15. Now compare 25 and 15. Whether 25 is greater than or less than 15? Yes, very good. 25 is greater than 15. So put greater than symbol in between. 25 is greater than XV. Shall we move on to the B sum now? Yes. X, I, X, and 38. Now you are going to tell me the answer now. What symbol will come in between? Now tell me what is the value of XIX. So value of X is 10. And what is the value of IX? That is 9. So 10 plus 9, 19. Now compare 19 and 38. Whether 19 is greater than or less than 38? Yes, 19 is less than 38. So put less than symbol in between. XIX is less than 38. So third one, 18. We are going to compare 18 and XVIII. Now tell me what is the value of EX? Yes, value of X is 10. What is the value of V now? Yes, 5. And we have 3 I's. So 1 plus 1 plus 1. So that is 3. So now tell me what is the value of 10 plus 5 plus 3. Add and tell me the answer now. Yes, 10 plus 5 is 15. 15 plus 3 is 18. Now tell me what symbol comes between 18 and XVIII. Yes, both are equal. So put equal to sign in between. 18 is equal to XVIII. Shall we move on to the next one? Yes. Roman numerals up to 100. This is one column. You can see the Roman numerals up to 100. One represent I. So 2i represents 2, 3i represents 3. So like that it goes on till 100. We'll see how to form this Roman numerals now. Yes, with these 7 letters of the alphabet. Yes. Next, in modern Roman numeral system, for large numbers, a bar is placed above the base numeral. A bar is placed. What do you mean by bar? This is a bar. It is placed above the base numeral indicating multiplication by 1000. When the number is a larger one, so a bar is placed. Shall we see that? Above that one bar is placed. What bar is placed? What is the meaning? What is the value? 5000. So 5000 X above one bar, that is 10,000. So 5,000, 10,000, then L above one bar is placed, that is value is 50,000. So C above one bar is placed, so value is 100,000. 100,000, that means, so value of C is 100 into 1000 is 100,000. Same value of L is 50. So 50 into 1000, 50,000. Now D above 1 bar is placed. What is the value of D? 500, right? 500 into 1000, 500,000. 500 into 1000, 500,000. What is the value of M? 1000. And above 1 bar is placed. So 1000 into 1000, 1 million. 1000 into 1000, 1 million. This is for larger numbers. Yes? Now we'll have some. So now we'll see the conversion of Roman numeral to Hindu Arabic numeral. So whatever the number we are using is a Hindu Arabic numerals. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, up to, that is a Hindu Arabic numeral, right? So we are going to see how to convert the Roman numerals to Hindu Arabic numerals. Shall we see now? There are some rules. So we'll see what all the rules are there. So first one, if a smaller number, if a smaller number is to the left of a larger number, if a smaller number is to the left of the larger number, subtract the value of the smaller number from the larger number. Let me repeat. If a smaller number is to the left, if a smaller number is placed before the larger number, means what we have to do? Subtract the value of the smaller number from the larger number. Shall we see one example now? Yes. Now example is ix. Now tell me, what is the value of I now? Value of I is 1. Yes. And what is the value of x? 10. So smaller number is placed before the larger number, right? So what you have to do? Now subtract the smaller number from the larger number. What is the larger number? X. What is the value of X? So 10 minus 1. What is the answer? 9 is the answer. So if a smaller number is placed to the left of the larger number, subtract the value of the smaller number from the larger number. So here the larger number is x. So x minus I. So 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1 is 9. So the answer is 9. Now we'll see one more example now. X, L. Now tell me whether x is greater than L or less than L. X is less than L, right? Because the value of X is, value of X is 10 and value of L is 50. And value of L is 50. So 10 is less than 50, right? So what you have to do? You have to subtract the smaller number from the larger number. Yes, what is the larger number? L. So what is the value of L? So 50 minus X. What is the value of X? 10. So 50 minus 10 is 40. So the answer is 40. What is the value of XL now? 40. Value of X is 10. Value of L is 50. If a smaller number is placed before a larger number, subtract the value of the smaller number from the larger number. So L minus X. So 50 minus 10 is 40. So next we'll see one. Next rule. Subtract only the values of letters I, X and C. You're going to subtract only the values of I, X and C. Values of V, L and D cannot be subtracted. You can subtract I, X and C, and you cannot subtract the values of V, L and D. What is the second rule? We can subtract the values of I, X and C, and we cannot subtract values of V, L and D. Shall we see one example now? Yes. Now I am taking one example, 45. So X, what is the value of 45? We'll see in Roman numeral. So X, L, V. how we got? Shall we see now? So what is the value of xl? So the smaller number is placed before the larger one, right? So x, value of x is 10, value of l is 50. So x is less than l, so subtract from the bigger one. So 50 minus 10 is 40. Then 40 plus, what is the value of v? 5. So 40 plus 5, 45. We got the answer right. So this is a correct one. So what we did is correct. And see this now. 45. So can we write like this? VL, we know that value of V is 5 and L is, what is the value of L? 50. If we subtract, so smaller number is, if the smaller number is placed before the larger number, we can subtract the smaller number from the larger one, right? So can we subtract 50 minus 5? No, we should not do this. This is wrong one, because the values of V and L and D, V, L and D cannot be subtracted. We cannot subtract the values of V, L and D. Clear, children, now? Yes. Shall we move to the next one? Yes. Subtract the value of only a single smaller numeral from a single bigger numeral. Subtract the value of only a single smaller numeral from a single bigger numeral. If you are going to subtract, you can subtract only once. We can subtract only once from a numeral. So we cannot subtract 2-3 times from a numeral. Subtract the value of only a single smaller numeral from a single bigger numeral. We can subtract only once from a numeral. We'll see one example now. So example 1, 8. What is the value of 8? So V followed by 3i. I. So value of V is 5. What is the value of I? 1 plus 1 plus 1. So 3. 5 plus 3, 8. So this is a correct one. And second one. So what is the value of 8? V, I. So now we'll see how to write, how we should not write 8. Okay. So second one, 8. X, I, X. What is the value of I? 2, right? And what is the value of, 1. So value of I is 1. Value of I is 1. And one more, the value of I is 1, right? And value of X is 10, right? Value of I is 1. I again 1. And value of X is 10. So, here the smaller number is placed before the bigger one, right? X is bigger. So, can we subtract X minus I minus I? So, 10 minus 1 minus 1. So, we cannot subtract like this. So this is a wrong one. So we can subtract only once from a numeral. We can subtract one time like this. X, this is correct. But we cannot subtract 2 times. Clear, children? Next. Do not subtract a numeral from another numeral which is more than 10 times greater. If the value is 10 times greater than the other one, we should not subtract that. Do not subtract a numeral from another numeral which is more than 10 times greater. That is, I can be subtracted from V and X because the value of I is 1 and value of V and X is 5 and 10. So we can subtract I from V and X, but we cannot subtract from L, C, D and M. Why we cannot subtract? Because the values are 10 times more than 10 times, right? So value of L is 50, value of C is 100. So we cannot subtract I from L, C, D, M. Similarly, X can be subtracted from L and C. You can subtract X from, we can subtract X from L and C. And this is correct. But we cannot subtract X from D, M. Because the values are more than 10 times, right? So we cannot subtract if the value is more than 10 times. Do not subtract a numeral from another numeral which is more than 10 times greater. That is, I can be subtracted from V and X, but not from L, C, D and M. Similarly, X can be subtracted from L and C and not from D and M. Now, next rule. If a smaller number is to the right of a larger number, if a smaller number is to the right of the larger number, add the value of the smaller number to the larger number. If the smaller number is to the right of the larger one, what you have to do? You are going to add the value of the smaller number to the larger number. Shall we see one example now? X, I. We know that value of X is 10 and value of I is 1. So 10 is greater than 1. So what you have to do? You are going to add 10 plus 1. So 10 plus 1 is 11. What is the value of XI? 11. Let me repeat. If a smaller number is to the right of a larger number, add the value of the smaller number to the larger number. So XI, value of X is 10, value of I is 1. So 10 plus 1, 11. Next one, if the number has more than 2 letters, if it is having more than 2 letters, what you have to do? Add the value of each letter to find the number. Add the value of each letter to find the number. If you are having more letters, what we have to do? You are going to add the letters. Shall we see one example now? L, X, V, I, I. So we have more than 2 letters, right? So shall we add now? What is the value of L? Value of L is 50 plus what is the value of X? 10. Very good. 50 plus 10 plus what is the value of V? 5 plus value of I is 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1. Shall we add this now? 50 plus 10, 60. 60 plus 5. 65, 66, 67, 68. So the value is 68. So if you have more letters, what you have to do? Add the value of each letter to find the number. So next one, C, D, I. C, D, I. So C, D plus I. What is the value of I? 1. Shall we find the value of C, D now? See here, smaller number is placed before the larger one. Yes, right? See, the value of C is 100. Value of D is 500. 100 is less than 500, right? So now subtract the smaller number from the larger number. So 500 minus 100 is 400. So plus I. 400 plus 1. 401. So value of C is, this is the value of C and this is the value of D. So D minus C. So 500 minus 100, 400 plus 1, 401. So we saw the rules for the Roman numerals, right? And here is a worksheet for you. Finish the worksheet. First one, choose the correct answer. Roman numeral C represent the number. What number it represents? C. Second one, Roman numeral for 11 is, any symbol can be repeated more than How many times we can repeat a symbol? So here we can repeat a symbol 3 times. We cannot repeat a symbol more than 3 times. Put the correct sign. So 27XXX, 3X and 1I. When a smaller symbol is returned after a larger one, then the values are dashed to get the number, whether it should be added, multiplied or subtracted. Next one, the Roman numeral M represent the number. So value of CD is, you're going to find out the value of CD. Roman numeral system is based on dashed letters of the alphabet. Finish the worksheet, children. See you in the next class. Thank you.